Hello, everyone. It's Seth, probably better known as Saffron Olive, and it's time for another Brewer's Minute. So this week, we're going to be jumping into the world of Commander and talking about some combos. This is 10 Commander combos that are legal for mono white decks. So they only use white cards or colorless cards. So if you're playing Commander, you can play these combos in your mono white decks. These combos, too, it's worth pointing out, are all legal in Legacy. So if you're playing casual Legacy or want to try to build a suite against the odds Legacy deck with any of these combos, it works there as well. I don't think any of them are legal in Modern, but there's still some super sweet combos to talk about, to build around. If you have some deck ideas or you use these combos in your Commander decks, make sure to let me know in the comments. Anyway, a quick reminder before we break down 10 Commander combos for mono white decks. If you enjoy Brewer's Minute and the other series here on the channel, it would be amazing of you if you could take a quick second, click that subscribe button down in the corner of your screen. It's a great way to support the channel and the site for free. So let's jump into our list. Starting off, number 10, we have Rest in Peace plus Helm of Obedience. So this is actually a really tricky combo. It shows up occasionally in competitive Legacy decks, not all that much, but every once in a while. Basically, Helm of Obedience lets you tap it to put X cards from your opponent's library into their graveyard, or until you hit a creature card. But we're not actually trying to hit a creature card. If we can get a Rest in Peace on the battlefield as well, Rest in Peace creates this replacement effect where instead of cards going into graveyards, they go directly to exile, which means when you activate your Helm of Obedience, even for just one mana, X can be one, you will just exile your opponent's entire library. One shot, kill your opponent by exiling their entire library. They untap, they draw their card, they lose to drawing on an empty library. So while this combo is a little bit mean, and I'm sure your playgroup will not like losing to it, it is a pretty effective way to one shot an opponent of your choosing in Commander. Moving on to number 9 on our list, we have a couple of different Sun Titan combos. Sun Titan with Angelic Renewal or Gift of Immortality. So with either of these cards, plus a sacrifice outlet like Ashnod's Altar, we can do a couple of things. We have infinite Enter the Battlefield and Dies trigger. So the basic loop here is you're able to sacrifice the Sun Titan, and then it comes back into play thanks to the Angelic Renewal or Gift of Immortality. And then when Sun Titan enters the battlefield, you get back the Angelic Renewal or Gift of Immortality, do it again. So you get infinite Enter the Battlefield and Leave the Battlefield triggers. So if you can figure out a way to abuse that, I'm not sure the best white way to do it. I know in black you have like Blood Artist, for example, or Impact Tremors in red would let you just kill your opponent directly, but you can figure out some way to abuse those triggers. If your sac outlet is actually Ashnod's Altar, you get infinite mana out of it too, although any sac outlet will do. So number 9, Sun Titan plus a sac outlet with Angelic Renewal or Gift of Immortality. Coming in at number 8 on our list, we got a sweet one. Outriders Encore, or actually any core can work, but let's use Outriders Encore as an example, plus Task Force and Animal Boneyard, Mirror the Moaning Well, Worthy Cause, something that lets you sack a creature to gain life equal to its toughness. So the basic idea here is with Outriders Encore, we can activate its ability for 0 an infinite number of times. When Task Force is targeted, we can get infinite toughness on our Task Force just by repeatedly targeting it with the free ability on Outriders Encore. And then after we get Task Force super huge, maybe 1,000 power, 1,000,000 power, then we simply sacrifice it to Animal Boneyard, to Mirror the Moaning Well, to Worthy Cause, whatever of those cards you happen to have in your deck. So if you're looking for a sweet way to gain infinite life that's a little bit outside the norm and in mono white, that is a great way to get it done. Coming in at number 7 on our list, we have Stormfront Riders with Cryptic Gateway, which is a combo that gives us infinite soldier tokens as long as we have at least one other soldier on the battlefield to get started. So Stormfront Riders enters the battlefield, forces us to bounce two creatures we control to hand, but whenever we bounce creatures to our hand, we get a soldier token, a 1/1 soldier token. Cryptic Gateway lets us tap two untapped creatures we control to put a creature that shares a type with them onto the battlefield for free from our hand. So the idea is we can keep tapping the soldiers we make with our Stormfront Riders to activate the Cryptic Gateway to keep putting Stormfront Rider into play, and we keep gaining one token, essentially, as we go through this process. When Stormfront Riders enters the battlefield, we make two tokens, we bounce Stormfront Rider plus one token, so every time we go through this loop, we're getting an extra token, so the end result is infinite 1-1 soldier tokens, really unique and sweet way to make infinite combos, plus Stormfront Riders is just a sweet card. You can pick up anything with Enter the Battlefield triggers to reset them. Just a really cool, fun card that probably should see more playing Commander. Coming in at number 6 on our list, we have another kind of pseudo-legacy slash vintage combo, Oriarch Salvagers with Lion's Eye Diamond. So this one's pretty straightforward. It ends up giving us infinite mana because Oriarch Salvagers can return Lion's Eye Diamond for just 2 mana. Lion's Eye Diamond sacrifices for 3 mana. So the end result is we keep netting 1 mana as we go through this Oriarch Salvagers loop. Of course, we do have to have a way of actually winning the game with that mana without having cards in hand, but we should be able to figure that out. Getting infinite mana is the hard part. We just use something in our graveyard, stuff with flashback, things like that that allow us to win the game. We can even get back other artifacts with Oriarch Salvagers if we need to. So a really unique way to make infinite mana. Coming in at number 5 on our list, we have some super sweet jank with Opalescence and Parallax Wave. So the idea here is Opalescence will make our Parallax Wave into a creature. We could also do this with Starfield of Nyx if we have a ton of enchantments out, but Opalescence turns our Parallax Wave into a creature, and then we can use Parallax Wave to do a couple of things. First off, we can just exile all of our opponent's stuff permanently. If we stack the triggers right, we exile all of our opponent's stuff. Then we use Parallax Wave to exile itself. Parallax Wave can return to the battlefield. If we stack the triggers properly, all our opponent's stuff will be exiled for infinity. We can also just do some sweet loops with whatever creatures we have on the battlefield. Keep getting back Sun Titans, whatever creatures with Enter the Battlefield, by exiling all of our stuff, then exiling Parallax Wave to itself, getting everything back. So we can basically wrath away all of our opponent's creatures and enchantments as well, since they will now be creatures, and do some really sweet shenanigans where we're blinking through our entire deck, probably setting up a game-winning, like, Ghost Away, Eerie Interlude-type loop, where we're just able to keep blinking our stuff until we eventually use it to win the game. Coming in at number 4 on our list, we're moving to the world of Stuffy Dolls, everyone's favorite combo piece. So the combo here is Stuffy Doll with Guilty Conscience. So you probably know what Stuffy Doll does. Enters the battlefield, you choose an opponent. When damage would be dealt to Stuffy Doll, it's dealt to that opponent. It's also indestructible. Guilty Conscience is a 1-mana enchantment that says whenever enchanted creature deals damage, Guilty Conscience deals that much damage to the enchanted creature. It seems very strange, but basically the idea of Guilty Conscience is you would put it on your opponent's creature, so if they attack you, it might kill itself. But if you put this on a Stuffy Doll, then you just ping Stuffy Doll with itself, with its tap ability. It deals a damage to the opponent that also deals a damage to itself, which deals damage to the opponent thanks to Stuffy Doll's ability. Basically, infinite damage until the opponent is dead. And then, of course, you'd have to figure out a way to reset it because Stuffy Doll chooses a specific opponent, like blinking Stuffy Doll, getting Guilty Conscience back from the graveyard. But it is a 2-card way for a pretty low mana cost that you can just kill any one opponent of your choosing thanks to Stuffy Doll with Guilty Conscience. Coming in at number 3 on our list, we have one of my favorite combos because it involves drawing lots of cards. So combo number 3, Well of Lost Dreams with Words of Worship. So Well of Lost Dreams, whenever you gain life, lets you pay X up to the amount of life you gain and you get to draw that many cards. Words of Worship is this really weird enchantment, lets you pay 1 to skip a draw and you're able to gain 5 life, which of course is going to trigger the Well of Lost Dreams. So then you can pay 5 mana, you draw 5 cards. One of the struggles with white decks in Commander is card advantage. And this is a combo that lets you have basically infinite pay 6 draw 5 in a mono white deck, which actually seems super strong just because the color struggles so much with the ability to be able to draw cards. Plus, if you can throw in some other life gain synergies, other shenanigans there, seems like it could actually be a pretty powerful addition to a Commander deck. So that's number 3 on our list. Moving on to number 2, we have Revelark plus Karmic Guide, throwing in maybe Triskelion and a Sacrifice Outlet. Basically, Revelark freaking karmic guide, go infinite by themselves if you have a sack outlet. So you Revelark to get back the karmic guide from your graveyard. Karmic guide gets back the Revelark from your graveyard. Back and forth, kind of like the Sun Titan combo we talked about earlier. You might be able to just win with infinite enter and leave the battlefield triggers, but if you can throw a Triskelion into the loop, karmic guide can actually get back the Revelark, but Revelark can get back two creatures as long as they have two or less power. So Revelark can get back karmic guide plus Triskelion, ping your opponent three times with the Triskelion, then you're able to get back the karmic guide to get back the Revelark to get back karmic guide plus Triskelion, throw in a sacrifice outlet, and you basically have infinite damage. You can kill all of your opponents with this combo if you just keep looping, pinging, looping, pinging, looping, pinging. If your sack outlets Ashnod's Altar, infinite mana as well. So super, super spicy. Number one on our list, we have one of my favorite combos because it doesn't win the game. It just annoys opponents like crazy. And that is Mycosynth Lattice with Stony Silence. So Mycosynth Lattice makes everything into an artifact. Stony Silence makes it so activated abilities on artifacts can't be activated, which means your opponents can't tap any other lands for mana. Also, you can't either, so make sure you have a plan for winning when no one has any mana. And this lasts forever. Like, every land your opponent plays will be an artifact and they won't be able to activate it. Their planeswalkers won't do anything. Their creatures can't have their activated abilities activated, so you basically just lock down everyone from doing anything, play through your entire deck, win the game, or build another way into your deck of winning without the use of any lands or any mana sources. So super sweet, really fun way to just make everyone miserable. I don't know if it helps you win the game that well, but it will make all of your opponents and maybe yourself miserable as well. So anyway, those are our 10 commander combos for white deck. So let me know what you think. Do you like these combos? Do you want to see us talk about more colors of commander combos in the future? Let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will talk to you soon. Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, help us out by clicking that like button down below. And to keep up on all the latest and greatest, click that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon to get alerts whenever we have new videos. And if you want to, check out some of our other sweet videos here and here.